Yeah, guys, I'm at the studio now, but none of the lights are working. I went to check the fuse box, but some kind of weird accident happened. It looks like somebody smashed it in with like a giant wheel. Oh no. Oh no! Oh no!
Every day we receive thousands of terrible VHS tapes and DVDs. Some are so fucking weird we don't exactly know what to do with them. That's why the Wheel of the Worst was designed. It's a torture device for the modern age. The wheel is spun 3 times. Each spin selects a video at random for the group to watch, and then evaluate which video is the best of the worst.
Well, we said it was dead, but it came back to life, just like Bob Hope. Do you remember when Bob Hope clawed out of his coffin at his own funeral? It wasn't widely reported in the media. I think the family was a little embarrassed. They had prematurely buried him. Don't ever join an improv group. Jesus fucking Christ.
Line.
Anyways, the Wheel of the Worst is back. Let's discuss the tapes that will torture us today. First up, this is an old favorite. The only repeats on today's wheel. We brought it back in the hopes of landing on it. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Worm Mania, live worms and song.
Well, that's just great. That's just amazing. Next we have Surfing for Seniors.
Well, so many broken hips and shark bites.
An introduction to the internet.
Oh, I would rather watch seniors try and surf.
I was hoping that's what it would be.
That would be really, especially if one had an oxygen tank on the back of the surfboard.
Would throw their balance completely
off. Yeah, and they just go, ah! We never saw Harold again.
The whole thing, nobody successfully surfs. They all wipe out instantly.
Rich, as a senior yourself, why do you hate your own kind? Next up is a tape that's all red for blood. Why it's riding mower safety.
Written in pen. So we're kind of taking on faith that that's what's in this box. This could be a snuff film.
Yes.
So I'm hoping we land on that.
We came from your home, so there's a good chance.
Next up is Hospital Clowning, presented by JT Bubba Sykes. They gonna tell us about the demon Eloise Cole?
Possibly. They all worship her. Their god of death.
The cult is spreading. It's a sequel.
Mm-mm.
We can only hope. We can only hope, Mike.
She's gonna make them all wear black Nikes, and drink cyanide.
Welcome to our comedy video. Next up is the Rejection Connection.
Oh, you should know a lot about this.
How did I know that was coming?
Tell me all about this video, Rich.
The fucking most obvious fucking thing you could have done. Jesus fucking Christ.
What are you, from Brooklyn now? You're trying to sell me a hot dog? Next up, casual slip covers. Create a beautiful new look in minutes. Why are you doing it slowly? Like I'm gonna want to stay on that. Oh no, please don't go to the next tape. You're gonna trick me. This is all you.
Meet Joe Colley in.
Joy.
I said Joy, didn't I? Meet Joe Colley in.
Meet Joe Colley in. Joy.
Oh, fuck. Meet Joy Colley in. A day
did you say
full
fuck
of
me,
joy.
Fuck me, Joy Colley.
Yeah. Hey, Rich, can we just make a note that Rich just said, fuck me, Joy Colley.
Oh, fuck me, Joy Colley in.
And let's go one step further and Photoshop their faces onto a pornographic image. What, Rich, let's talk about this. In all seriousness, meet Joy Colley. In a full day of joy. It's made by the right group. And apparently this is Joy. She looks very happy. She has a cartoon possum kissing her.
Mole or something.
She has a cat and a doll. So maybe this lady's just so, so fucking charismatic, she deserves her own video.
I don't know. We're all this time talking about tapes we're not going to land on, because we're going to land on American Lung Association, item number 6224, Octopuff in Kumquat.
Oh, boy.
9 minutes, 8 seconds.
All right. That's clearly the most exciting tape we've come upon.
Wait, I didn't hear that. What's the name of the tape?
The name is American Lung Association, item number 6224, Octopuff in Kumquat. 9 minutes, 8 seconds.
Is it Octopuff and Kumquat, or Octopuff
in Kumquat?
What is an Octopuff?
Well, I'm gonna extrapolate.
Is that some kind of Pokemon?
Octopuff, it's considering it has the word puff in the title, maybe it is a drug, like a thing you take when you have lung cancer?
Are they gonna teach kids not to smoke by using, like, knockoff Pokemon? Like, this is Octopuff.
Yeah.
Octopuff has horrible lung cancer.
He smokes 8 cigarettes. It's not, well, the box.
Gotta catch all the cancer. So if an octopuff is an octopus that smokes, I don't want to know what the fuck a kumquat is.
Richard, I think you're getting a little too creative here. I'm going with standard. I do not think we're going to see a cartoon octopus smoking 8 cigarettes.
But first, my name. Let me introduce myself. I'm Octopuff.
It's now time to spin the Wheel of the West.
Rich!
Oh my God!
It's time to spin the Wheel of the Worst! All right.
I'm gonna spin, but remember, no redos this time.
Oh yeah. That's an important thing to mention. No redos. We're going full on. The three videos we land on are the three videos we're watching.
All right.
Hospital clowning!
All right!
Hey, not bad, this is a good job, Rich.
You know, hey, I could have done worse.
You could have done worse.
Hi, I'm JT Sykes, also known as Bubba the Clown, and today I want to talk to you about hospital clowning. Hospital clowning is a viable ministry effort.
And no.
Oh, no!
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 We're stuck, Rich.
Here at the hospitals.
One of the things that you understand about it,
hello, I'm Dr. B. Wacko. See, I'm the head doctor. That's right. Yeah. And this is what my completed character clown outfit looks like. Pretty sexy, huh?
No.
That's not appropriate.
He's just sexy.
He's yeah. sexy.
There is something.
There's something to this guy.
Okay? That's right. He blew chunks all over me.
Now, that was a very misleading cover because this clown is not in the video. This is an unrelated clown.
That's true. I thought he would be doing some of the Howie Mandel stuff with the surgical gloves.
Well, why don't we spin again?
Oh, okay. Oh,
oh my God, it's Wormania with Mary Appelhoff and the Brennan Kids.
Woohoo!
You're a music guy. You know the Brennan Kids,
I sure
right?
do. Let's...
And Mary Appelhoff.
Oh, she's a worm woman.
Wormania!
Have you ever seen a leaf disappear into the ground? It was probably a worm, yes, pulling that leaf down.
Dad, what are you watching?
I'm watching a worm drag a leaf across the ground.
Why are you watching a worm drag a leaf across the ground?
Because it's fascinating. So I thought I'd just have to write a song about it.
Fascinating?
Yeah.
That's right.
Oh no! It's Mary Appleby.
Worms, making worms.
Oh, what is that?
It's just a bunch of worms fucking.
So it's an orgy?
It's a worm orgy. A worm-gy.
Video was banned in 5 states. Landmark Supreme Court.
Are they adding that waviness, or is that the worms doing it?
That's the worms.
I'm gonna throw up.
I'm gonna throw up.
What's the worm gonna do with that leaf?
It's going to eat it.
Yeah, so when a worm needs our something to munch, it drags a leaf down into its hole for a lunch.
Ooh. Oh, there's the light.
So what are we talking about?
We're talking about worms.
What are you singing about?
Oh my god!
Ooh, a worm is a disgusting creature that lives to eat bacteria. Thanks, Grandma. Well, this is our last chance.
Oh, okay.
Spin number three. I'm hoping for Octopuff and Kumquat, or possibly a film about how elderly people can use the internet. I didn't have a good grip.
No, it's okay.
Octopus! Kumquat! I did it!
Yes!
No!
Oh, fuck!
We can fix it, Rich.
What the fucking words? Octopuff and Kumquat?
Yes! Yes!
Nice to see you. I guess you wonder who I am. Perhaps you think I'm Bam or Slam. Or maybe I'm just who or what. Maybe you wonder what I've got. Well, what I've got is lots of stuff. But just my name. Let me introduce myself.
No redos this time. No redos this time. No redos this time.
I got a worm in my. I got a worm in my. My worm's gonna go in the. My worm's gonna go in the. Rich Evans wants my worm in his. He's always asking for my worm in his. It gets uncomfortable when he asks me for these questions. It gets uncomfortable when he asks me these questions.
So, on this final episode of Wheel of the Worst,
our second annual final episode,
of Wheel of the Worst, we
even though the wheel is destroyed.
It's in pieces.
Oh my god.
We should point out, I guess we can show photos of it. It cracked right down the middle of not only the backboard, but the wheel itself, right down the center. And it's all because of that pin, I guess.
There was a bolt that was sticking out of the back because of the adjustments, modifications that were made.
Not just modifications, that's the spoke.
Yes.
Yeah. But that's the way the wheel turns. It's necessary.
Yes. And for you Wheel of the Worst historians out there was a wheel before this that was two different types of wheels.
Only the face, like the actual base has been the same.
Yes. The wheel was changed.
Yes.
This is irreplaceable. and now it is broken. Yeah.
Yeah. But there was an incident where the Wheel of the Worst was knocked over prior to this by Jack Packard.
Woo! Fuck it!
Oh, fuck!
And that makes it okay.
And that made...
That makes it okay because Jack Packard did it.
Yes.
If Jack would jump off a bridge, you also jump off a bridge?
I would.
Yeah. Well, I think what Mike is getting at is that this right here, it's Jack's fault.
Yeah. He set the precedent that it was okay to knock the wheel over, and I did it.
You know what Jack didn't do? He didn't watch Hospital Clowning.
That's true.
I wish he would have. He could have given us some valuable insight.
He might have liked Hospital Clowning because Jack's a fucking clown weirdo. But Mike, would you tell us about Hospital Clowning?
Okay, well, our first video is Hospital Clowning. Done in the SF Collegiate font.
Very nice.
I don't know why. It has nothing to do with clowns. But the clown pictured on here looks like Pogo. I mean, it's like creepy. Yeah. And it looks... It looks nothing. It looks like a John Wayne Gacy painting.
Welcome to our comedy video.
It looks nothing like the clown in the video, so somebody else made this.
Well, the video, the first 15, 20 minutes is these bullet points, and then the rest of the video is just kind of his routine.
Hello, I'm Dr. B. Wacko.
There was a point early on where we were like, oh, this is a backdoor Jesus video.
How hard it's going to be a gospel clown or a hospital clown.
Is the clown thing just a big front to convert before they die? As in, like,
deathbed. Otherwise, you wouldn't need to emphasize the gospel clown part. This exists for deathbed conversions.
And it really wasn't. He just brings it up a couple times, almost to the point where it's like, why bother bringing it up at all?
He's faithful and he wants to let everybody know, and it's important that he get the gospel out to everybody, but not super important.
What's more important is that you buy his clown props.
Yes. Yes.
They're very inexpensive, but yet they're a witnessing track. Everything a person needs to know is right on this bill.
It's Jesus. It's Jesus bug costs two real bucks.
No.
Let me tell you something. When a parent...
Is that a Bigfoot?
He's supposed to be a clown, but he's too cheap to get color printing.
This is Bigfoot.
In JT Bubba Sykes' defense, other than the packaging on the video cassette, he never really hawks his website.
No, we were waiting for that, because you looked it up, and he has a site where you can buy clown merchandise. So we were waiting for the pitch.
Yeah.
We were waiting for this whole thing to be a lead up to, and you can get any of these wonderful clown items on my website, but it never happened.
That's the weird thing is we're so affected by cynicism with videos. We're like, what's the angle? When's he gonna do this? It seems like it may have come from a genuine place, which is very rare.
The healing power of laughter is nothing to take lightly.
The shocking twist of this video is that this guy, he doesn't want to pressure you into loving Jesus. He doesn't want to hawk his cheap wares. He just wants to tell you about the experiences he's had being a hospital clown.
And he might be trying to educate and or convince or motivate you to become a hospital clown.
He doesn't really go a lot into the hows of it. I mean, apart from the makeup demonstration.
And I'm going to make just two little tiny eyebrows right above my regular eye.
Good work, cameraman. Nice work, makeup job. They're completely
uneven.
What the fuck?
You suck!
For the benefit of showing you what I'm talking about, let's take these lines and make them just a little thicker and see if we can get a little bit better balance.
Nope.
It's just riveting.
Nope, that's worse.
Or you could take it off and do another take of the video.
But I'm not going to worry about that also.
Why bother getting it right?
What if this is the first time this guy's ever put on clown makeup?
Kind of looks like it.
It sort of felt like he was making it up as he went along. A little bit.
It seems like he's blundering through it because he is. This is not a very professional product.
And you put it right under your arm like that, and you stand over by the booth, and you go. You press the button. Well, not that one anyhow. I didn't want that one to work.
This is your professional video!
You can always cut that out.
Well, nice little gadget here. I like to show people all the time.
Oh, I guess that's just it. You just won't use it.
Nope.
Move on.
Dead on it.
Forget that part.
Well, that's a weird angle to it as well. Is he kind of is like he's talking to children, but really he should be talking very adult. You gotta call up the hospital. You gotta talk, and he's like, call the administrative office. Tell them, hey, you know. And it's like, wait, who are you talking to? Who is your audience? Yeah. Is it little kids, or is it like rational adults who aren't pedophiles?
Yeah.
Who want to go to a children's hospital to be a clown?
How many instructional videos that tell you how to be a clown hospital are there?
I don't think we've watched a single video that taught us how to be a clown hospital.
Yeah. I'm curious to see that one.
I would like to see that. Yeah.
I really do want to see
let me do this
again. Not many patients come out alive from a clown hospital. But ironically, they could fit a lot of patients in a clown hospital.
A clown hospital is...
it's quantity, not quality.
What? Did you get my joke?
Huh?
A clown hospital is like where they cut you open for surgery and they just start pulling out like handkerchiefs.
They give you a heart transplant. It's just like a balloon heart.
Yeah, aww. Yeah, which we see in the video.
But my point is, there aren't many instructional videos for how to become a clown who works in hospitals. He doesn't have like a template to look at. How do you do this right? This man is breaking new ground.
Never, never, never. Watch my finger. Never, never, never. Don't touch a covered part of a person.
No shit!
Only touch the uncovered.
Yes.
Only touch. Half the fun is uncovering them.
You probably, like, I would be like, okay, I'm fine volunteering at a hospital. I don't mind helping people. I think it's a wonderful thing. I would not want to put on clown makeup. It takes a very special, special, disturbed person to put on clown makeup.
I went to the nurse's station and I said, is there anybody here that needs special help? I was on the geriatrics ward. Geriatrics, I'm sorry.
In the genealogy room.
Where they do research.
In the gene splicing room.
There are horrible creatures everywhere. The genetics testing laboratory.
This is maybe the only copy of this, and he made it for his friend.
There's no pitch. Yeah, there's no, yeah. Get this, buy this, you need this.
We're so used to the sleazy, like, ulterior motives in these videos.
That it's shocking. It's blowing our mind.
Yeah.
It's literally blowing our mind.
It's hard to make fun of this guy.
Like, this is the tree stand you should be using.
Yeah, exactly.
I feel like this could have come in like a get started kit. Where it's just like, it's, you know, like, here's how you get into hospital clowning, and then here's your clown white, and here's some balloons, and like, it could have been all part of that, like, included free, because he just wants to help.
So I got nothing against Bubba Sykes.
It makes it very hard to make jokes.
Out of our three villains.
I'm glad I came here today, because I'm glad I had an opportunity to tell you and to share with you just how much God loves you. Anybody got a tissue here?
Well, the next movie that the wheel landed on, not that it's a movie of any kind, is Worm Mania. And I don't know, just because there's music in it, Josh.
Sure.
Tell us about Worm Mania.
Sure. In Worm Mania, we meet a family that writes songs about worms that they see on the TV, and then an old lady helps them learn more so they can write more songs.
I'm Mary Applehoff, the worm woman from Kalamazoo, and I speak for the worms.
Dad, she just talked to us. How did she do that?
She seems to have a genuine love for worms.
Yeah.
In the same sort of way as this, where it's kind of pure-hearted.
That's because it's trying to get away from the light. And that's why I always use my red light when I look for night crawlers at night. Worms aren't as bothered by red light.
This is just bizarre.
Like, she just seems to really love worms, which is, I don't appreciate because they're fucking gross, and everything she says is creepy and weird.
Adult worms produce them when they breed.
They breed?
Make babies.
Yeah, let's talk about this now.
Well, in fact, each worm has both sexual parts.
They're both? At the same time?
They're hermaphrodites.
Let me show you.
When worms mate,
should our dad be here when you talk about this stuff?
Yeah, she's the worm woman of Kalamazoo, self-proclaimed, and everything she knows is about how worms fucking shit.
It goes in as dead matter like leaves and comes out as fertile soil.
So talking about worm poop, it might sound rude, but worm poop is important plant food.
Ew, I'm gonna throw up.
Yeah, what are we talking about?
We're talking about worms.
Where's mom?
My mom, she left. They couldn't stop singing about worms.
Fair enough.
The family is a legit family because they all have the same last name.
They're the Brennan kids?
Something like that. The Brennans. Yeah. Julian, Shannon, and James, along with their father, Billy.
Yeah.
Their mother is nowhere to be seen.
She could be related to the mother. She could be like their aunt. It could be all a family product.
We'll never know.
Mary Applehoff is the creepy aunt.
So what are we talking about?
Worms.
We're talking about worms.
So what are we singing about?
We're singing about worms.
Oh, that was great.
No,
with all the cats.
Totally the creepy aunt.
That lives alone and reads lots of romance novels and
cats.
Is obsessed with worms.
She doesn't have cats. She has worm bins.
This is a worm bin. bin. It's an aerated container. We'll create a habitat for worms using newspaper and soil and water. The worms will feel right at home.
But she loves worms so much, she's completely oblivious to the fact that everything in this video is absolutely disgusting.
Now, Shannon, you can mix it up with this worm fork.
Okay.
What is she
doing? She's turning the wall!
The fuck is she, Blair Witch?
I can't watch this Blair Witch.
Oh!
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 Fuck you!
These came out of my body!
You should, like, regurgitate them?
Oh, yeah!
Oh. She is infested with worms, and so... And so she had to learn about them because Mary gets inside.
See, I picture Mary Applebottom meeting up with Mr. Brennan in like a dingy bar smoking cigarettes, like it's somewhere in Michigan going, you can do music?
Yeah. Oh, it's an open mic night.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, Mr. Brennan just wants a gig, so he shows up and they'll give him a couple drinks if he plays his dumb songs.
He's singing on stage and she's in her like worm outfit. And, you know, and
with the hard hat.
She's smoking. She's like dark lit in her face. And
no, she's got the red light.
Oh, yes. And she meets up with Mr. Brennan after the show and says, I have an idea for a video. And it's like this really epic backstory. We're going to make millions selling this to public schools.
This is getting grosser and grosser.
Is there an underpinning sexual component to this?
Well, there's sexual elements to the video.
Your finger represents the worm, and this ring represents the cocoon.
Oh
no!
Oh, this is strange.
Orange sperm sacs where it picks up eggs and a sperm needed for fertilization. The cocoon then slips off the end of the worm, closing off on both ends.
Like this. Eat it.
Exactly.
But then later, after the discussion of how worms mate. She's like, they strip off their slime from their worm bodies like this, and then he has this index finger out, and she's like going like this with like
yeah.
the thing, and it's very bizarre. And then the big moment came when Grandma Worm, Grandma Applebottom Worm,
Auntie Worm
filled up a balloon.
James, will you please fill this balloon with water?
Gladly.
What? What the fuck was that?
Say the line again, just more sexually. More sexually charged.
Oh, God. Everything about this is disgusting.
This balloon represents two segments of a worm's body, and my hands are the worm's circular muscles. Just like this balloon, the worm.
Massage this hot dog.
Uh-oh. It's getting weird again.
Grandma looked like she knew her way around
squeezing worms.
A big, big worm.
Filled with fluid, eggs and sperm. Then the eggs are fertilized.
I'm gonna throw up. Don't zoom in.
So yeah, she's obsessed with worms. She's talking about the worms having sex. She shows the reproductive process of worms. Right. And then they cut to footage of just a pile of worms like writhing together.
Yeah, it's really
and
disgusting.
And I'm assuming it's worms mating in a group, like an orgy, like an orgy of worms.
That's the way it's kind of played.
Yeah, and it's just like slimy and disgusting, and it's just really gross.
It was so disgusting, I know.
What do you have there?
Hmm? Oh, it's the world's largest gummy worm.
Well, we're still talking about the...
We're talking about worms having sex and being covered in mucus.
Oh, okay. It's not... I'm sorry. Is it distracting? You can keep talking.
It looks tough. Don't you have to, like, tenderize that?
Well, yeah, I guess.
Yeah. Just get that... Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, which side is the anus?
Does it matter?
It can be, I don't know. One or the other.
It's not very specific.
No. Yeah.
Well, just to be sure, I'll eat both ends.
Oh my God.
I think I'm gonna barf.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, I don't want it to
touch me!
Oh, no!
No! Oh.
Oh, I'm sorry. You were talking about worms?
Hey, look over there. I'll bet we'll find worms under that bag of leaves.
So, the last video the wheel landed on ever was Octopuff and Kumquat.
In Kumquat.
In Kumquat.
That's important.
Was it worth it, Mike? Jay, would you like to tell us about a day full of joy?
Well, we watched Octopuff and Kumquat, and we had very little to say. So
we were right, though, that it was an octopus that smoked.
I do not think we're going to see a cartoon octopus smoking 8 cigarettes.
So we're not going to make fun of it. We're going to talk about A Day Full of Joy with Joy Cowley, who I think I might hate more than anyone ever. This is an ego project for Joy Cowley. She's a Kiwi. She's from New Zealand.
You racist.
And this video is all about how amazing she is, how interesting she is, how great her children's books are, which are the worst fucking things ever.
Here they are again. The meanies.
What?
The meanies came to school one day.
Is there context?
The meanies came to school one day.
Guess what happened next?
I have no fucking clue.
They ate our pens and pencils. Guess what happened next?
And the meanies walked on the ceiling.
Shut up.
What happened next?
No!
And Mike said, shut up.
Shut up! If I wanted to listen to Joy Crowley's repetitious books, I'd watch the video again.
Do you want to watch the video again?
No.
We all cleaned up the mess.
There's nothing joyful about that fucking story.
Did you like that story?
No.
Would you like to be a meanie?
Yes.
The books are very basic. They're like for kids just learning how to read.
Which would be fine if she wasn't so full of herself, because the rest of the video is like, I'm so quirky and interesting.
How do you write?
How do you be creative?
How
Let
do
me
be
tell
creative?
You about how I'm creative. And I have eight cats, and one of them is named Chumbawamba.
When I'm not fishing or writing, I spend time with my animals. I live on a farm, and the animals keep me company. I have eight.
Fuck is this?
There is Bill. That's Dick. Dick is my greedy cat. This is Maggie. Now Maggie is the mother of the next three cats you're going to see.
Oh God!
She's gonna tell us about all eight cats.
Really?
Haagen-Dazs
is named because she's got a white smudge on. Also, I have plenty of sheep and chickens.
We don't care. Who are you talking to?
Well, the entire time she's talking about her eight cats, there's like a little thought bubble showing the cats, but like blocking the foreground right in front of her is like a giant goat.
Sheep.
It's a sheep.
Oh, is it a sheep?
Yeah.
I don't even remember. Okay.
It's Jay, do you not know the difference between sheep and goats?
I just didn't remember.
Okay. You fuck them both.
On my 60th birthday, I did a bungee jump. Let me tell you, it was a piece of cake. I jumped off the bridge where bungee jumping first started.
Who the fuck cares?
Wow, that was fun.
I hope she gets eaten by a weta.
Okay, a journey of her lifetime. Apparently, I remember they showed like old black and white footage that was like,
It wasn't real footage. It was faked. It was like supposed to be her as a kid.
Sure.
She liked reading.
I liked reading so much. I wrote a red book on my bike on my way to work.
Wait, is there child labor in New Zealand?
There were no child labor laws yet in 1956. I had to go to work on my book. And but
see the cable factory.
So the most the memorable moments of her lifetime was she read a book when she rode her bike, and then she bungee jumped when she was 60. Not a whole lot happened in between.
Cats. But she's the most amazing person because she went bungee jumping.
She's very interesting.
When she was 60.
Yeah. So
she had a midlife crisis, and that makes her special.
But mostly, I like to write in my office with all my favorite things around me. I have my bulletin board.
Me!
But Joy, where do you get your ideas?
Other than elderly people that are full of themselves that we hate, the running theme of this episode is what is the point of these videos?
Yeah.
Little kids that like worms, one person in the world that wants to be a hospital clown, and... This tape is most confusing of all.
It's ego. It's I am special and everyone wants to hear about me.
Let me read the back. Maybe we could shed some light. Okay. I'm sorry, but I have to. Introduction.
Uh-huh.
Share the adventure of the meanies came to school as Joy reads aloud. Includes a surprise
visit.
As Joy
reads aloud. Yes.
We should say that there are CGI meanies that pop up in the school and attack a janitor. Robert Duvall.
Robert Duvall.
They got Robert Duvall for this.
You're fired.
Last segment. You can write too. Stuck for ideas? Joy takes you into a forest and shows you dirt.
Now let's have a look down here because we've looked up tall. Now let's look down very small. And here you will see what the ground looks like under all the leaves and the twigs.
That's where they realized the video was only 5 minutes long. How do we pad this out? This should take some kids and they'll look at the fucking dirt.
But like, okay, a little kid would not get entertainment from this.
No.
Is the purpose of this video that educators in school, public schools or whatever will watch this and go, those books she reads are great, I will buy them.
It might be a book selling tool.
Oh, lovely mud. Said the cow, and she jumped in it.
Is it a video made by a crazy Kiwi?
Yes.
I get ideas from the world around me, from things that I hear, from things that I see, but I also get ideas from things I remember.
Well, it could very well be the Right Group is a group that makes videos for highlighting children's authors. And she answered her phone, hello, this is Joy, you know. We want to make a video about you. Come to Washington and talk to kids in a classroom. Oh, I'm busy feeding my cats. Bugger off. And then they're like,
take care of all my sheep.
They just keep hounding her. We're villainizing Joy. And really, she just wanted to be left alone with her cats and her sheep and write her terrible books.
It's possible.
And they're like, come on, you gotta have something to talk about. Well, we went bungee jumping.
Josh.
I'm trying to get to the truth.
No. I'm talking the New Zealand accent. You got it there for a second.
Bungee jumping?
Yes.
Bungee jumping.
Rich is just doing Australian.
I've got a look.
I know, I can't do accents.
No,
I'm getting into it. Yeah, I've got a lot of kits. I went bungee jumping.
Yes. Bungee jumping. Yeah, it's got a little bit of the higher end.
You're losing it.
I slip into the British Cockney a little bit.
Yeah, you got right around.
It's very hard.
See, that's the problem. Ooh,
when you hit those high notes.
Yeah. Bungee jumping.
I hit the high notes. I gotta go into work. Work is very easy.
That's a good one. Work.
Head. No, it's gone. It's gone. You want to slip into Cockney. That's the natural...
I could tell the Cockney. You chop out all of your set of balls. Fuck you, Joy.
Safe.
Yeah, I mean, are we?
Yeah, I think that's it.
We're not picking the best or anything.
Do we mind?
Well, we have to do.
Do we?
We have to have.
We don't have to. I've learned that over the years.
We have to have a fucking wrap up to honor the final appearance of the wheel.
All right.
Oh, our bulb just died.
Fuck. Everything's fucking breaking.
Oh my god. Remember the other two times that we said that the wheel was never coming back and then it came back because people seem to believe the things that we say?
It's never been fucking bisected before, Jay.
It got thrown in the dumpster once.
It's gone forever and the wheel will never come back ever again.
There's no possible way that we could find a way to fix it or replicate it. No. That's not possible.
It's not like
anybody here made it with their own bare hands.
Yeah.
It just appeared one day. There's no way we're getting this thing back.
Yeah. And so Jay, what tape do you think won?
I think Best of the Worst is Worm Mania. Just because it's a weird elderly woman that's obsessed with worm shit. And that's interesting to me. This is pretty pure-hearted. I hated this. I hated that woman. She wasn't interesting in any way and didn't warrant having her own VHS tape made. So it's Worm Mania for me.
Okay, Mike?
Wow, I just want to say everything you said. And I'm torn between these two. This is bizarre. Straight up fucking bizarre. But Worm Mania, I learned a little bit about worms and I had a couple laughs.
Well, I am going to echo you both. I mean, I smiled pretty much every time Mary Appelhoff was on camera because she was so
excited.
She was so sincere, but at the same time terrible at being on camera.
Yes.
Josh.
Can't pass that up. Worm Mania for the win. It had songs, it had entertainment, it had everybody running around and being in a 90s sitcom kind of feel.
Strange sexual innuendo.
Innuendo. There was a straight up fucking in that video, Mike.
Yeah, that's right. There
straight
was.
Up fucking.
There was sexual intercourse between worms and between grandma and the teenage boy.
James, will you please fill this with
gladly.
All right. Is there anything we would like to see destroyed, Josh?
Oh no, not the kumquat.
I gotta put it up there. I gotta put it up there as an option.
This is for me.
Well, I would say for me personally, no tapes deserve destruction. The only thing that deserved destruction is sitting behind us all right now.
I'm with you.
Like a bitch.
It really did.
You didn't even put up a fight.
It just
fell over. The Wheel of the Worst was done in by the American Lung Association.
You know what? It does represent a public danger. I can understand where they're coming from.
And you could say it took its last breath. The American Lung Association. Oh my god, you hit one of Joy Colley's cats.